Hi guys, it's Carolina from Gotaluvpolish. Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new. So I just want to start out with what I have on my nails today. I just put lotion on so my nails look a little bit wet and oily looking, but it will go away after a while. What I have on my nails today is Ethereal's Banana from the May 2020 PPU. I love it. It definitely comes off a little bit darker on the nails. I did do 3 coats with this because I felt like it just covered up the visible nail line a little bit better. This one can definitely be used as a topper. I still like it because it shimmers in the sunlight so beautifully. But yeah, that's what I'm wearing on my nails in case you guys are wondering. Also, I'll be reusing some of my swatch wheels for this video because I don't want to have to use another brand new roll. Oh, I forgot to mention, today's video we are going to be talking about my polish pickup for June 2020. Now, this polish pickup came in after July. June ended right before the start of July. So I guess June 30th or 31st. I can't never remember how many days are in June. Right before the 1st of July, my polishes came in and I just haven't had time to do anything with my videos or anything. So I did not record. Today is the 6th of July when I'm recording this video, and hopefully, fingers crossed, I'll get it uploaded this week. Now, my haul for July polish pickup is insane. Like, insane. So I just want to give you guys a heads up on that. I kind of went crazy in June polish pickup because I had some gift cards for my birthday in May that I was able to purchase a lot more polishes than I intended to purchase in June, which I appreciate everybody who sent me gift cards for my birthday. That was very sweet and thoughtful. I didn't expect it, but I really appreciate you guys doing that for me. Before we get to the swatches, I wanted to talk to you guys about some of the non-nail polish products that I purchased from Polish Pickup. As per usual, I bought my Acetone Antidote, and this is Lit Dole Whip, which is a pineapple smell. Unfortunately, I don't know what I was thinking when I purchased this. I love the Acetone Antidote. I basically get them every single month. But this was pineapple, and I hate the smell of pineapples. I hate pineapples. So I'm kind of sad that I purchased this. It smells, I mean, everybody says that it smells good. I don't like the smell of pineapples. I must say that it smells good because it smells like pineapple to me, and like it does a good job of imitating the real smell. And that's why I'm gonna say, yeah, it's good because it reminds me of pineapple for real. So yeah, not loving this one, but not because it's not a good product. I just don't like the smell. So I did purchase Lantern and Wren's stamper and scraper set. I have been trying to test out different stampers and scrapers. Oh my gosh, I can't get it out. There we go. So I've been trying to try out different stampers and scrapers because my favorite stampers of all time is basically on its last leg. It still stamps. It still does a pretty decent job at stamping, but it has acetone over it. It has I can see little tears on the clear jelly part. I mean, it's a really, really old stamper. So I'm trying out different ones and I've heard good things about this brand. I love shopping at lanternandwren.com. So I figure I'll try their stamper and see how I like them. And so the last thing I bought that's not nail polish related is this, Esmaltes de Kelly, and this is a, you know, themed, it's perfectly tied with the theme of, you know, cocktails and mocktails, I think the theme was for this month. And it has a lot of fruit images, some flowery images, you know, because you think about fruity, fancy drinks in the summer. So yeah, a lot of interesting little like cocktail images. I just thought it was really cute. I feel like I probably have a lot of these images already in other separate plates, but I do like the fact that I have them all in one. I mean, I definitely don't have any images like this, but I think I have an image similar to this one and maybe these flowers, but it's still a really pretty plate and I really, like, it attracted me when I saw it. The first polish that I'm going to talk about is a Wildflower Lacquer. Now, Wildflower, this one is called Cherry Smasher. Now, Wildflower has been, like, I've been buying a lot of Wildflower Lacquers lately. They've been killing it for me. If you guys have been here any time at all, you guys know I'm a big, big fan of like flakies. I love flaky bombs. And Wildflower has been killing it with these flaky bombs. I want to say since Don't Play Coy, I've been eyeing them. I didn't get Don't Play Coy the first time, but I am getting it in July Rewind Month. I zoomed you guys in a little bit more so that hopefully you guys can see the awesomeness that is this polish. Now, I will let you know that my best friend already has started or has used this polish, and she's wearing it right now. In fact, I thought it was really funny because she was just like, she loved it. Oh my goodness, look at that glow. And you guys know I'm all about some red glowy polishes. Now it does lean a little bit warmer red, and that's first swatch. We'll see how it goes after the second, possibly third. I would wear this in three coats, even if it covers my nails up. I'm repeating myself. If you've been here before, you already know, but I use three coats for flakies. I have to, it's a thing. The next polish that I'm gonna talk about is Patty Lopez's Indie Polish, or Indie Polish by Patty Lopez. And this is called Celebrating with Friends, and it's another red. I can't help it with these reds, man. So this is another red with black glitters, and it looks like holographic glitters in it. And I think there are some bigger red glitters in there. I'm not sure, I haven't swatched it yet. But this one just called to me. There's something about this look. Anything with like black glitters in it tends to draw my eye, and anything that's red and black glitters definitely gonna draw my eye. So I decided to get this. This is the first time I've ever purchased Indie Polish Patty Lopez. So this is the first swipe with Indie Polish Patty Lopez, Celebrating with Friends. And as you guys can tell, it's already showing up a little bit more pink tone, lighter, cooler tone than the Wildflower Lacquer. So that's cool. There's already a difference, so I don't have to feel like, oh my gosh, I got two red polishes, you know, because I am trying to like steer away from my safe polishes that I like to wear, basically. Another new to me brand, this is Hurricane from DRK Nails. I've never purchased this one, but I have seen lots of people wear this and talk about this brand, and it looks like it's a really good brand. I really love this whole look. It's just the typical polishes that I gravitate towards because I have a style that I tend to go for, and this one definitely called my name. Okay, I already can tell you I really like this brush. It feels very soft when I'm applying it. Like sometimes I feel like you can tell the density of the brush when you apply it. So I like that look. It's obviously very sheer, has to be for the flakies to go through, but I'm definitely gonna need 2 to 3 coats for this one. But I really like that color, that looks really pretty. Another sort of new to me brand, I just started shopping for Fancy Gloss this year. In fact, I want to say I placed my first order of Fancy Gloss in June. If I remember correctly, I placed my first order of Fancy Gloss in June, and this one is the Toxic Bitch Thermal. Technically, this would be my first Fancy Gloss because I purchased this and then I purchased an order from the site. But yeah, so this is the Toxic Bitch, and this one reminds me of Britney Spears for some reason when I saw that. But anyways, I'm not much for thermals, and this is a thermal, but for some reason, every time I kept seeing pictures of this one, it kept calling to me. I'm gonna see if I can warm it up by holding it, because I'm pretty warm right now. I just came back from going grocery shopping, and I'm pretty warm right now. Oh, you can't really tell. We'll see if I can get it on the swatch wheel. I've done that before by accident. So here we have Fancy Gloss, the toxic. maybe I shouldn't be saying that so often in my video. I don't know, is that a thing? I try not to cuss in my videos, and like now I'm saying this word over and over again. Oh my goodness, that is so pretty. Like, oh my gosh, I'm just so into these like golden green, you know, multi-chrome flakies with like in a blue base. I'm definitely feeling it. Oh my gosh, that looks so pretty. I love that. Hopefully, if once it dries a little bit, I can see if I can warm it up with my hands, because like I said, I'm pretty warm right now. Another not new to me brand, but one that I've been buying a lot lately is this one from Ethereal, or this, the brand is Ethereal, and this one is called Dragon Drink, and I could not say no to this polish. I have so many pinks and purple polishes with flakies, but none of them quite this color. I love it. Love it, love it, love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. Okay. So here we have Ethereal's Dragon Drink. Oh my goodness, guys. Again, I can feel how smooth the brush is on Ethereal, and the formula, it just glides on. Like, no dragging, no issues with Ethereal's formula whatsoever. What a beauty. A true love classic for me, and this is polished for days, sees the day. Wow, look at this beautiful polish, guys. I love it. This, like, I don't even know, like greenish seafoam green kind of color with all of these beautiful colorful flakies in there. Oh my god, Jenna's just a genius. I freaking love this so hard. All right, so here we have our first coat of polished for days, and as per usual, beautiful, beautiful formula. I can definitely tell the difference between those brushes, man. Like, seriously. Not that the brush from Polish for Days is bad, but I definitely can tell. And here we have another thermal. This is Fair Maiden's Ain't No Laws. And like I said, this is a thermal. I really don't remember what it shifts to, but I remember that I was seriously impressed when I saw it on the previews, and so I decided to get it. Again, I'm not normally one for thermals, but for some reason, I'm just seriously feeling them right now. Yeah, I can't get it to transition like that, but we'll see if I can get it to transition later. Here we have Fair Maiden Ain't No Laws, and again, super sheer coat, first coat. Beautiful shimmery action. In real life, you can see a lot of that green shimmer shine through, and these darker orange bigger flakies in there as well. Very cool. I really like that. The last polish I'm gonna talk about for June's polish pickup is Painted Polish, and this one is Hold My Butterbeer. I love, 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 love Harry Potter. I don't always get the Harry Potter polishes, but I really do love their polishes, or I really do love the Harry Potter book series. It's my favorite. Not big fan of the movies, but anyways, this one was super unique. You see that pink purple flash there? Oh my god, I love it in this dark murky base. This right here, fall in a bottle, guys. Fall in a bottle. I love the way that this looks. Okay, here's Painted Polish Hold My Butterbeer. Oh my goodness, this murky murky polish looks so cool with those flakies. Oh my gosh, look how pretty. Oh, I got some on me. Look how pretty, guys. That is definitely a fall polish, and look how it glows. Oh god, I can't wait to wear this polish. I can't wait to wear all of these. Of course, it's gonna take me forever, but it'll get done. All right, guys, I am going to wait until these dry a little bit more. I'm gonna add a second coat. In real life, I'll probably add a third coat, but I don't think I'm gonna waste my polish by adding a second coat to the swatches. So you'll see it in two coats and top coat when I come back, and then we'll talk about that. Okay, so I have done two coats of all of the polishes and one coat of top coat. So we're gonna start over here. I'm gonna start right here, which is the first polish I swatch, which is Wildflower Lacquer Cherry Smasher. Oh my goodness, guys, look how pretty that looks. I'm just a sucker for some red polishes, especially dark, deep jelly reds with beautiful flakies like this. They just do me in every time. The second polish that I swatch is Indie Polish Patty Lopez, and this is Celebrating with Friends. Again, this one came out to be a little bit more pink tone red. It gives it more of that like bright cherry red look. rather than the Cherry Crusher. This one I feel has a little bit more of a cherry red look. I really love those scattered black glitters in this polish. I think it just makes it look so interesting. We have Dark Nails, and this one is Hurricane. This one looks so pretty. It's definitely a me color. Like, when I knew it as soon as I saw it, it's just one of those colors that I gravitate towards. I really like it. I think it'll look better with three coats. It's showing up a lot more vibrant and interesting in real life than it does in the monitor right now. It doesn't look as interesting on the monitor. I really like the way that this looks on my skin tone, though. It's like very flattering. I have Fancy Gloss, and this one is the Toxic BITCH. I actually had to look up what this one transitioned to because I can't get it to transition at all, and I don't remember what it was. The Toxic B is a tri-thermal that transitions from dark blue, cold, and to teal. Wait. That transitions from dark blue and cold to teal when it's warm and to bright neon green when it's hot. Oh my gosh, look, it's actually transitioning. I was reading, I didn't even notice. So yeah, the formula is on a little bit on the thick side. I still liked it. It did get a little dull. Oh wow, that looks so cool. That looks really cool. I don't see a third. I see mostly the dark to neon hot green, basically. But that looks really cool, guys. Did you guys see how it was transitioning? Oh gosh, I love it when I see it happening like that. But what a difference, and look at that color. Ooh, I love it, I love it. Yeah, that's why I couldn't stop staring at that. Dragon Drink from Ethereal. So right here we have the beautiful Dragon Drink by Ethereal Lacquer. Oh my gosh, just kills me. And then we have Painted Polish Seize the Day. And Painted Polish Seize the Day is just such a pretty, delicate, like, I don't know. And then we have Fair Maidens Ain't No Laws. Again, this is another thermal. Hopefully I can show what it turns to. I want to say it turns to a yellow. Let me see if, yeah, it's turning a little bit more yellow. This one is a little bit more subtle compared to the Fancy Gloss, but you can see it how in the middle it's a little bit more of the orange and on the outside is a little bit more of the yellowish kind of color. Yeah, it's very light, very subtle transitioning compared to the other one. And finally, we have Painted Polish, Hold My Butterbeer. Oh my gosh. And this, again, it's like fall in the bottle, guys. Like, just fall in the bottle. It's so perfect. I am ready to wear it. And at the same time, I'm not, because I want to wear all my bright colors. So yeah, those are all the polishes that I received for June Polish Pickup 2020. What did you guys receive in your orders? And of course, then I have the three other things. The Lantern and Wren Stamper, I got the Acetone Antidote Dole Whip, and the EDK Stamping Plate. But that's it. I think I made another big order for July. And after July, I'm going to try to be on a strict no buy for the next 3 months. We'll see how that works out. But I just feel like July rewind month, I have a lot of polishes that I need to go through, and I want to go through some of them before I keep adding more and more and more. I've also purchased a lot of other polishes from sales and stuff, so I'm going to try to slow my roll a little bit. But anyways, these are the polishes I got for June Polish Pickup. Let me know in the comments down below, what did you guys end up getting, and do you love them as much as I do? I'm very happy and satisfied with everything that I received for June. It did take forever to get to me, but it's here now. So let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.